Oh, hello there, I'm Wangeline. Look, I've been making some intelligent dance music earlier this day, and for some weird reason my mom's living room is now this strange mechanical mess, and I'm kind of stuck here, so this is my life now, but you know what? Let's talk about noises and audio and music and all that garbage. While we're on the topic of strange noises coming from my mom's living room... No, wait. I found a way to take this bad, like noisy vocal recording and turn it into this perfectly chaotic and strange ambient garbage. And just in time for Halloween, it sounds beautifully frightening. Oh, hello there, my dear and beloved patron supporter, Van Carter. What do you mean it's too late for me to make a video about spooky things? Okay, look, I started working on this video way before Halloween, and it's not my fault I'm bad at finishing things on time. Or maybe it is, but, you know. You know what, I'll just make the video anyway and pretend like people aren't tired of pumpkins or words like spooky in the title of a YouTube video in... December? Okay, yeah, I've got things to do. Bye! Okay, spooky ambience, yeah, I've got it like right on me here. Have a listen. I'm sure you'd like to know how I made these good mythical noises, don't you? So, let's talk about that.
Let's talk about that.
I kind of stumbled upon this technique on accident, actually. It was late in the night, and I was just mentally drifting into another dimension while a livestream by the YouTuber Luna Oi was running in the background. I didn't pay too much attention and just kept it there for some background noise, but at some point, she started to sing quietly and I felt like I could record and play around with it. It's so bright. Turn it off, please. And who are you? Ah, my child. My dear child. I am... Wimbleheim. I notice you're talking about recording other people for your own auditory purposes. I mean, don't you know anything about consent?
Yeah, okay, I was just about to mention that.
It's very, very important to ask people beforehand if they consent to you using their voice in your projects. Otherwise, if they find out, you're the bad person, and it's gonna be really fucking awkward.
Okay, wow, you swear in my video? Get out. Now, please, really, leave. You're just a pointless excuse to use way too many visual effects in my videos anyway. Please, just let me continue talking, or else this video's like going to take another month to finish again. Okay, fuck.
I asked her if she's okay with me sampling the livestream, and she was fine with it, so I just opened up the free screen recording software OBS and recorded a little segment of the stream. I then just slapped the recording into another project I was already working on for a while and just kind of forgot about it. At some point though, I wanted to use my keyboard to play some piano, but at the time I didn't know I still had the livestream recording selected, so the chord I played on the MIDI controller was not played by the virtual piano, but by the quiet singing of Luna. And to my surprise, it actually sounded really interesting and pleasing, so I began exploring that technique even more. This was the moment I realized I could process this a bit more and create some beautiful textures with these weird singing chords. First off, it's important that the speed of the recording for each note isn't changed by the pitch, or all the individual notes would slowly drift away from each other and it would really quickly get disgustingly dissonant and not as pleasing as it is right now. And then I saved all of that and began processing this mess to make it sound even more, interesting and appealing, I guess. All of the processing that I'm about to explain is done through destructive workflows. In the context of this project, this means that I burn my changes into the previous files and cannot undo any specific step in the processing chain. If you're wondering why I'm doing this, I made an entire video on this topic and why you might find this type of workflow useful. Feel absolutely free to watch that as well, and other than that, here we go, processing. At first, I copied the main audio, pitched it up by an octave and layered it on top. It also sounds quite neat when you offset different layers, so they don't all just blast your ears at the same time. I added a bunch of reverb and delays at different speeds to add to the moody and misty atmosphere, and saved that as well. The good thing about this technique is that if you have noisy or just dirty recordings, that's totally fine because all the compression artifacts, keyboard noises or mouse sounds, or just the noises of dropping pencils get mangled in the processing steps as well. This really adds to the chaotic nature of the soundscape and creates a bunch of beautiful details later down the road. I honestly would even encourage you to add usually unwanted noises here, just to see how it sounds. And then reverse the audio, put even more delays on it and made sure to set the delay time to random numbers, just so it's chaotic and there isn't much of a rhythm in this. At some point I also added an equalizer and automated some frequency valleys and peaks, so they move around the place as we go along. This adds even more small details and movement, which I always find very appealing in soft and ambient products like this one. It makes it all feel a bit more alive and the whole listening experience becomes just that tiny bit less monotone. At this point, I usually layer on some recorded ambience like subtle wind noises or like water splashy sounds, just to fill the whole scene a bit, but all of that is totally optional and you can do whatever you want because, you know, it's a free country.
Well, hello there, I'm Wangeline and you're listening to ASMR. And what is plushies?
But other than that, this is it. Enjoy your vivid soundscapes and make sure to leave a comment with, I don't know, some ideas for further processing or just your thoughts on this art technique. If you enjoy my videos and want to support me, you can go into patreon.com/mingling and throw a few dollars at me if you wish. And as always, I'd obviously like to thank all my current patrons for supporting my channel and keeping this garbage alive, which are Tubbin, Alex, That's My Jam, Scotchadef, Great, Christy Kamori, Zach LM, Captain Bubs, Anarchoic, Lunati Cultist, Annabelle, Katana, Misty Burgess, Chant Magic, Sophia Figueroa, Sora, Lettle, Foxy Vivi, Hetera Bjver, Windu, Mikkel Armstrup, Benjamin Burns, Ariel Ariel Berard. Yeah, I definitely mispronounced that one.
I'm sorry.
Dive to the Heart. Rachel Ray Mills. Rachel Ray Mills. Or Rachel.
I'm not sure. I need to ask them about this.
Robert Rurik Willett. Jane the Human. And Alex. Again, thank you so much for watching this video all the way through and for the support, and now I'm exhausted and tired. Once this video is uploaded, I will just jump into bed and fall asleep for 9 years. So, see you then. Bye. Good night.